This video provides valuable information on how to ensure that your cameras are properly integrated into your security center system. It emphasizes the importance of reviewing the supported device list before adding cameras and provides guidance on how to troubleshoot connectivity issues and re-add video units if necessary. Before adding units to your security center system, it is important to check the compatibility of the units with your security center software version. This ensures that your security system operates smoothly and efficiently. Open a browser and type the following URL. On the SDL page, you can filter by camera, intercom, access control, and Stratocast devices. You can also use the search box to filter for specific devices. For example, if you want to integrate an Axis P1448 unit, you can apply multiple filters, such as manufacturer and device type, to narrow your search. To quickly determine whether a camera model is supported, simply enter the model number in the search box and hit Enter. This will display all units models containing that information. For example, if you look at a unit P1448-LE, you can see that it is supported in Security Center version 5.7 and above, and the latest supported firmware on the camera is 11.2.61. Clicking on the model will provide more information about the unit. Please take note of the different firmware versions, certification levels, and Security Center versions mentioned on this page. A very important note, supported since implies that this firmware or device will automatically be supported in all future Genetec software releases. Lastly, it is important to know that a camera with multiple imagers may consume multiple licenses. For example, if your camera has four imagers, you will notice in the configuration tool that the unit consumes four camera counts. In this event, you will need to upgrade to the Security Center version that the camera was tested against to ensure compatibility and proper licensing. If you encounter an error message that says "fail to add unit" while adding cameras in config tool, it is important to remember that selecting the correct product type for the unit is a crucial step to avoid this problem. By ensuring that you have chosen the right product type, you can prevent any issues that may arise and make the process smoother and more efficient. If you ever come across a red unit in config tool, don't worry. There are a couple of simple steps that you can take to resolve the issue. First, try reconnecting the unit to the archiver using the reconnect option. If that doesn't work, you can use the ping option to verify archiver to unit connectivity. By following these quick and easy steps, you can quickly narrow the problem. If the previous steps did not resolve the issue, removing and re-adding the unit to the archiver may be necessary. To do this, select the unit and click Delete. But be sure not to delete the archives, as this will result in loss of video. Once deleted, Ghost unit will appear in the area view. Return to the video tab and add the unit.